It's common in Washington, people leaving their government jobs and then cashing in for big, lucrative salaries. Those stories tend to make the news. Less publicized are junkets to foreign lands, often ones with abysmal records when it comes to human rights and democracy, such as the conference held Tuesday and Wednesday in Azerbaijan.
It's a government that doesn't look very kindly upon dissent, and in the recent crackdown, there have been dozens of protesters and political activists, dissidents, government critics, bloggers who have been arrested mostly on bogus charges, thrown in jail.
Excessive restrictions on freedom of expression and freedom of religion, torture. And yet, this week, former government officials were treated to luxury travel and accommodations in a city where the Azerbaijani government's beautification campaign has meant, Human Rights Watch says, the forcible eviction of thousands of families and illegal demolition of their homes. And when these former government officials speak, as did former top Obama White House advisors Jim Messina, David Plouffe, and Robert Gibbs, they're handsomely compensated, tens of thousands of dollars. Republicans were in attendance as well, according to the program online. Former top State Department official from the Bush administration, Paul Wolfowitz, and former Republican Senator Dick Lugar.
It raises questions about whether the public interest is always the number one interest when these folks are going abroad and collecting five-figure checks.
Current members of Congress were also listed as attending, though they would not have been paid. Where's all this money coming from? Every day, Azerbaijan pumps 1 million barrels of oil through its new pipeline. So perhaps not surprisingly, this week's conference was sponsored by a coterie of oil and gas companies, including BP, ConocoPhillips, Chevron, and the state oil company of the Azerbaijan Republic.
Former high-level officials convening for an event that brings the country prestige shows how important the country is.
In an email, one former government official who attended but who requested to not be named tells CNN that there's another angle here, that one thing all these stories fail to mention is the alliance we have with Azerbaijan on energy, counterterrorism, and most importantly, Afghanistan. Without their logistical and supply routes, we could not do what we do, especially when we've had Pakistan shut things down.
This, you know, could encourage dialogue, this could encourage progress, but certainly we would expect our government officials and we would expect our highest public servants to be good ambassadors abroad. But at the same time, we don't want at all the appearance of selling access.
The former government official also told me that for context, it's not uncommon for, quote, people like us, in fact, former presidents, to speak in Russia, China, and many other countries with democracy and human rights progress to make, and far less cooperation in other areas than Azerbaijan. Plouffe, Messina, and Gibbs declined to speak to CNN on the record, but they told us that former White House counsel Bob Bauer checked out the invitation and the payment and said there was nothing inappropriate about the trip. They also say that they brought up Azerbaijan's human rights record in their speeches.